So I made a red velvet cake sometime back and everyone seemed to love it. For that love of red velvet, we're making red velvet cookies today with white chocolate chips. It's an incredibly simple eggless recipe that calls for very basic staple kitchen ingredients. Let's get started. Let's start with the dry ingredients first. In a small bowl, I'm adding maida, which is all-purpose flour, 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. Using a whisk, I'll give this a quick mix, and once all the ingredients are nicely combined, I'll set this aside. Now in a large bowl, I'm combining 1/2 cup of salted softened butter. Into this, 1/2 cup of superfine sugar and 1/2 cup of soft brown sugar. So for all my cookie recipes, I like using both white and brown sugar. While the white sugar gives my cookie some structure, I add the brown sugar to give it that chewy texture that I really like. I use the soft brown sugar from this brand called Tate & Lyle. In case you don't have brown sugar, you could skip that completely and use 3/4 cups of white sugar in total. Now using a whisk, I'll cream the butter with both the sugars until I get a mixture that's light and fluffy. Now into this, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and 1 tablespoon of red food color. Once this is in, we'll mix it in as well. Now let's dump in our dry mix that we had set aside earlier and we'll mix it in as well. At this stage, your dough will look very crumbly and sandy, but keep mixing it because we'll be adding in milk later to bring everything together. Now to bind our cookie dough, I'll be adding in buttermilk, which is essential to any red velvet recipe and gives our cookies that classic red velvet flavor and texture. To make the buttermilk, I'll be combining 3 tablespoons of milk with 1 teaspoon of white vinegar. We let it sit on the counter for about 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes, you'll notice that the milk will start curdling. If you don't have white vinegar, you can also use lemon juice in its place. Alright, so my cookie dough is ready, and now my least favorite part of the recipe, which is to chill the dough in the fridge for about 30 minutes. It's an extremely important step, and if you skip it, in most likelihood, your cookies will spread way too much in the oven, which we don't want, so let's pop this in the fridge. So it's been 15 minutes since my dough has been in the fridge, and it's the perfect time to preheat my oven. I'll be preheating my oven at 180 degrees Celsius, and this takes about 15 to 20 minutes. It's an important step so that once my cookies go in, they start baking immediately. I'm also prepping my baking tray here and lining it with a silicone mat. This ensures my cookies don't burn on the bottom. In case you don't have a silicone mat, you could use a layer of parchment paper or 2 layers of aluminium foil. Now using an ice cream scoop, I'll scoop out equal size balls of my dough and place it on the prepared baking tray. Now I'll put these cookies in the oven at 180 degrees Celsius for about 12 to 15 minutes. The trick here is that I'm not adding the white chocolate chips on top right away. From what I've seen, the white chocolate chips tend to burn and brown in the oven, which I don't like. So I'll be adding them on top only a couple of minutes before I pull the cookies out. So the cookies are cooked almost all the way through. Now is the perfect time to add the white chocolate chips on top. Now this goes into the oven again for a couple of minutes. Thank you. Trust me, these are not your regular cookies. I think they make for the perfect edible gift. So if you're planning to surprise someone for their birthday or make them feel special, bake a batch of these red velvet cookies or just make them for yourself because you're special as well. I'll see you guys next week. Happy baking.